Welcome back to IAA 2025. It is still the press day, and I'm still here on CATL's stand because the company produces more than just one type of battery pack. And the CATL has been in the news a lot this year. Lots of new technologies that have been unveiled over the course of this year. And back at the kind of the early part of the year when CATL had its tech day, it unveiled a technology called its Freevoy dual battery system, or dual chemistry system. And I'm here with engineer John, who's going to tell me a little bit about the system and its flexibility. Thanks for talking to us.
Okay.
So right now we've got this very interesting display here for your Freevoy dual power system. Mm-hmm. In a nutshell, explain to me the advantage of a dual chemistry battery pack.
Okay, the first one is for the battery, we have two different areas, and then we can choose a different chemistry. So we can combine the, you know, different chemistry have different advantage. So we can combine the different the advantage together for the battery. And also it's two parts of the battery. So even one cell, the thermal event happen, the other battery also can provide the power to the vehicle to take the passenger to a safe place.
Right. So Freevoy has the benefit of offering different combinations of cell chemistries in a pack that is better targeted towards what the end user wants.
Mm-hmm.
So you could pick, for example, you've got some bricks here that are representative of the different chemistries,
yes.
Right? So this one is LFP,
yeah.
So we could make that our primary energy source.
Yes.
And then we could use your self-forming anode,
yeah.
LFP, and we put that in, and this little screen here tells us what those two chemistries offer together, right?
Yes. And from here you can see, if you use LP with LP cell forming anode, you can achieve the more than 1,000 kilometer range and also the 5 minute fast charge. So it can provide a very, very good performance for the vehicle.
And the benefit of having multiple chemistries instead of one is that some chemistries are more expensive than others, right?
Yes.
So LFP is pretty affordable,
yes.
as a chemistry anyway.
Yes.
But let's go to NCM, and that is the chemistry that most current generation EVs are using. Has a great power density.
Yes.
Very good for acceleration.
Mm-hmm.
Not good for long life.
Yes.
And that can be paired with, for example, we could pair that with LFP,
LP,
right?
Yes.
And LFP doesn't perform so well in cold temperatures.
Yes.
So we have a pairing that allows you to still have good performance in cold weather.
Yes.
Are there any cell chemistries that you think work really well together?
Mm-hmm. So to be honest, it depends on the different requirement for the customer.
Right.
So some customer want to, for example, in the North Europe area, the temperature is quite low. So some people want to use MC, and also like sodium ion is also a very good choice.
Right. So the sodium ion, the sodium ion batteries, and you actually have another battery over there, the Nextra, which is fully sodium ion.
Yes.
CATL has worked really hard on sodium ion technology.
Mm-hmm.
20 years ago, sodium ion just wasn't practical because it required a high temperature to ensure that the battery didn't literally just solidify and stop working. Now, obviously, CATL has worked to enhance sodium performance.
Yes.
Sodium is much better in cold weather now, isn't it?
Than
LFP.
Yeah.
So you could actually combine your LFP
with
your sodium, and then you'd have a really robust battery that benefited the long life of LFP.
Yeah, and also very cheaper.
Right. And obviously sodium ion doesn't use as many expensive materials,
yes,
right?
Yes, so it's very, the cost would be very low, and also can give the low temperature performance.
Right.
So it would be better than pure LFP.
And so when a customer comes to you and they say, hey, I have a battery, I have a vehicle I want to make, these are the characteristics.
Mm.
You then sit down and go, these are the options. this is what we can build.
Yeah.
And right now you have it 50-50 in your demonstration, but there's no reason you couldn't have 25-75, right? It doesn't have to be completely half.
It depends on the different requirement, the different condition.
Right. Is there any that you are particularly fond of? Any particular pairing that you like, that you personally, your favorite?
Personally, to be honest, LFP for the long life and the low cost. And also SCM, self-forming anode, with a very, very long life. Very, very long range.
Right.
So for this case, I can achieve safety, long life, long range, fast charge.
And these are very energy dense as well, with the self-forming anodes, because you're not putting an anode in the pack. It's coming from external.
Yes, it's like a power bank to provide power to the Menzu. And also the energy density can achieve more than 1,000 watt-hour per liter.
Yeah, which is incredible.
Yeah, very high.
Incredible. So right now you can offer this in all different vehicle sizes, right? Mm-hmm. From small city cars to all the much buses and beyond. Is this useful in static battery applications, or does it not really translate well, because in static battery projects you're generally much more predictable in terms of energy use?
You mean what's the current status for the battery?
So
it's still under development, we cooperate with a different OEM to develop this battery together, and I think it will be SOP in the soon.
Right, and let's talk a little bit about the translation, because different cells have different characteristics.
Yeah.
So some cell chemistries are known for having a high voltage drop when you produce a high current.
Yes.
Obviously, each of these cell types have different voltages, individual cells. So how do you match the different cell voltages, the different internal cell resistance, and also the discharge, preferred discharge and charge curve?
Yes, different chemistry have different behaviors. So we have two BMS for each battery.
Right.
Then they can make each battery have the separate control by their own BMS.
Right.
So it will not conflict by the different chemistry in the vehicle.
And if something was to happen to one of the packs, you can continue to operate using the other one?
Yes, yes. So this is dual means two different battery. So it's because we consider this condition, the vehicle drive on the high speed way. So for example, if some event happened, in original cell, original vehicle, you have to stop on the high speed way. To be honest, it's very dangerous because the vehicle, the speed is very fast. So for the dual power battery, the other cell also can use, and it can provide the power to make the customer drive to the safety place.
Right, right. And when you are working with battery designs for individual customers, you obviously, I know that CATL has a big after-sales service around the world.
Yes.
Is there any difference for requirements for servicing for this technology compared to a single chemistry?
Yes, of course, because the chemistry is different, so we have the special method to monitor the sale and also give the aftermarket service.
Great. Well, thank you so much. It's a really interesting idea, really interesting design, and hopefully we can see the benefits of dual cell chemistry moving down into production vehicles, because it ultimately lowers the production cost of the vehicle, but it also makes the life of the battery a lot longer. So thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks so much for watching the video. It's a really fascinating discussion to see all of the interesting battery cell chemistries that are being innovated and brought to IAA Munich. There will be more from the show later on. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss anything out.
Thanks for watching us today. You can connect with us on Patreon, Discord, Mastodon, Blue Sky, or through our website. Huge thanks to the amazing folks scrolling by right now. You're the reason we can stay independent and keep making content without corporate influence. And right now is a perfect time to join. Through September and October, we're running our autumn Patreon drive. Sign up and you'll not only support the channel, but you'll also get an exclusive piece of digital art from Erin. Want to see your name here too? Support starts at just $1.50 US a month, and you can even gift memberships. And of course, a massive welcome to our newest members. NYTMR, Chris Wright, C&K Adventuring, Andy Pyatt, Gerald Eden, Carlacos, Chip Chandler, Robert Nelson, 00 Critical, Tom Fagden, Barry2379, Mike Coffeen, James River, Eric Knack, Hans Rose, DW, Merrill Fratkin, Kristen Rasmussen, MX, Minivar Vargas, Stephen Nichols, Panther Legion, Kitsa Prida, Bark Eater J, Jeff Good, Conrad Zalance, Frank Snyder, Jeffrey Smith, Tony Roberts, Matthew Frake, Jacqueline Cockburn, Fritz Coker, Trans Vegan Cyclist, Jade Diaz, Laura Shear Clark, Everett Garnett, Peter Broadwell, Jerry, Jeremy Redmond, Patrick Matthias, Pamela Not Pam, Dave Fry, Mark Anderson, Tal Hobson, C. Daniel Tideman, Martin May, Fee, Donovan, Date Downs, Matthew Buckar, Zach C, Taraki, Kathy Windandy, Alex, Patricia Connor, Lindy Melendez, Damron Can, Gary Robottom, Dave Miles, Tina Ponish, Mark Kruger, and Tyler Walker. Thank you all for joining in the last month. You're helping us hit our goal of growing Patreon support by 20 to 40% this autumn. Prefer a one-off contribution? We've got Ko-fi, Bitcoin, and a PO box, our swag store, and even an Amazon affiliate link, so your money helps us, not Jeff Bezos. We post new videos every few days on the main channel, plus extras on Transport Evolve Take 2. And since YouTube comments aren't safe for us anymore, the best way to chat is through Patreon, Mastodon, Blue Sky, or our website. If you want more, the algorithm thinks you'll like this video, but we'd love you to check this one out too. Be awesome, be kind, be intentional, and never forget to resist. Keep evolving.